मैया इंग्लिश प्राइमरी स्कूल क्लास सिक्स एंड द सब्जेक्ट इज़ इंग्लिश एंड द चैप्टर इज 3.2 एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज सेवन सिस्टर्स. सो वी हियर वी विल सी द पार्ट टू ऑफ दिस चैप्टर दैट इज द फोर्थ स्टेट फोर सिस्टर वी हैव स्टडीड इन द प्रीवियस दैट इज इन द पार्ट वन. सो नाउ वी विल गो टू द नेक्स्ट वन दैट इज द मिजोरम विच इज़ ऑल्सो नोन हैज द ट्रैवल गाइड. Now here we will talk about the Mizoram. Mizoram is the land of the hill people because mostly the whole state Mizoram is situated at the hill. So that people is known as the Kukis. The hill people, the people those who live on the hill, that is the land of the hill people. The another name it is given as a Kukis. So here we will see the many different types of hills. That is the lush hills, sheer cliffs, serene lakes, and the many waterfalls also we can see here. The hills are here stretched across hundred of miles, and here we can see many plains and the valleys, which is covered with the lush forest. That is the with the thick bamboo groves, and we can see here the very greenery fields also. With the diversity of the wildlife means in the forest we can see the many different types of wildlife also we can see here. So many of them here come to visit here. So for the traveling in the Mizoram it is a little bit difficult because but it has its own rewards because here we will see the natural beauty. Here we can see a very good scenery also. And the capital of the Mizoram is the Aizwal, which is the scenic location. That means it is totally a very beautiful and the scenery location it is. And here also we can see the Langwar River Valley in the west and the Turail River Valley in the east. And another thing is that that is a very famous thing, that is the city, that is the Zarkwad. It is the museum. In the heart of the that is a very good that here we will see the culture of the Mizoram with the collection of many different types of costumes, artifacts and many historical things also. And one more biggest lake is there in the Mizoram, that is the Palak Lake, which covers how many acres? That is the 74 acres, that means 30 hectares. Here we can see the very good fertile vineyards which is known as the fruit bowl of Mizoram, that is in the Champai. It is in the Champai, which is very fertility vineyards. The name is the fruit bowl of the Mizoram. And here we here in the state also we will see the different types of birds, wildlife, that is the flora and the fauna. And we can visit here the national park also. How many national park? Here we can see the two national parks and six wildlife sanctuaries. In the previous state also we have seen many famous national parks was according to their state it was the. So here also in the Mizoram also we can see two national parks and six wildlife sanctuaries is there. And here the official language is the Mizo because in that places widely this Mizo languages was used. So this was our Mizoram. Now next we will talk about the Nagaland, which is the Konuma. Here is the next sisters, that is the next state Nagaland. It is one of the very smallest states of India, which is also known as the Switzerland of the East. Why it is said as the Switzerland of the East? Because here the landscape is the picturesque and here we can see the colorful sunrise and the sunset also. And we can see here the flora and the fauna which we are talking about. Here the flora is a lush and the verdant and here the land is very beautiful. And the state capital is the Nagaland's capital is the Kohima. And all mostly the state is covered with the mountaineers. And here one more thing we can see here, that is the highest peak which is known as the Mount Saramathi, which is the height of about 3840 meters. because it is naturally it is covered between the Nagaland and the Burma. And here we will see the many tribal peoples also is there. That means how many tribes is there? Here the 16 tribes is there and sub tribes is also there. And their inhabited is in the hill state, because mostly that peoples live in the hill state only. And there, and this Nagaland have their own unique, colorful and very much designed costumes, jewelry and many other thing is there. But they have their own unique design. They are not copying of the other state designs. And the young people of that Nagaland used to wear fashion designing clothes that they used to create with the fabrics, which is they are traditional with the modern things. And their land is called as an idol place, because there the many things is going on, like trekking, rock climbing, jungle camping, because the tourism used to visit there for this things. That's why this land is known as the idol place. And it is also one more famous things is there in the Nagaland, that here we can get the abundant of the medicinal herbs also. Many medicinal herbs leaves also we get here. And it is also known as the Falgun capital of the world. Why it is said as the Falgun? Falgun is a great Indian hornbill. It is one of the most famous birds found here. And Nagas are the lovers of the fun here. That is means Nagas, who it is a Nagas means the people of the Nagaland. That is known as a Nagas. They are all lovers of the fun here, because the life is one long festival here. Because the dance and the songs and many other things, it is a part of their life. Most of the dances was performed with the beautiful rhythm. And they will live a colorful life. And they used to appreciate their own ethnic customs and the traditions, because they have their own unique songs, their dances and the festivals. So that's why it is known as the here cultural heritage. So we have to visit there in the Nagaland also. Now the next and the last one is the Tripura. The last seven sisters, that is the Tripura, that means the last state. And this state is the third smallest state in our country. If we will comparing to in our country, the third smallest state is the Tripura. And their border is to the Bangladesh, to the north, south and the west. Why the word Tripura is given in the state? That means it means the three cities. Means Tripura also means the near water, because at that time scholars used to believe that the land was ruled by the ancient times, ancient king. That's why it was named as the Tripur, because it was emerged at that time. That's why it is given as the Tripura. At that time the land was the three geographical zones. This land was in the three sides, that is in the three geographical zones. It was in the one part hill ranges, which runs from the north to the south, and the next is the plateau land, and third one is the alluvial plains, that is a low lying alluvial plains also we can see. And here many rivers used to nourish by this land, and they many peoples used to use the agriculture. That means their activities was there in this land also. The chief among them are the Gumti, the Muhuri and the Feni. That means many cultivations was there, agriculture was going on in that. Many thing was there, that is the rice, cotton, jute, tea, tobacco and the oil seeds. These were the mostly cultivated things in that state. And Tripuri peoples, in the Tripura, the people, those who live, that is known as the Tripuri people. They used to speak the language as Kok-Borko. That is the major group of the people used to speak this languages, because they were the tribal peoples and the sub-tribal peoples. And other languages also generated there, that was the Bengali and the Manipuri people also existed. That means in that state, these types of peoples was also living with the people of the Tripura. So that language is also generated in the Tripura. And one more main thing is that there was a major road. Only one major road was there. That is known as another name. It has been given the National Highway, which is connected with their land with the rest of the country. By moving from one place to another, that means one country to another, there were one major road, that is the National Highway. And the capital city of the Tripura was the Agartala. Here the people used to come for the tourisms, for the ecotourisms also, for the ecosystem, and for the archaeological also the people used to come here. And we can see here the tea gardens. Tea gardens is also the wildlife sanctuaries, and especially the eco park was set up there, and it gives a very great attraction to the people. Now the Neer Mahal, which is a very beautiful and very gorgeous, that is the red and the white water palace was there, which was known as the Neer Mahal, which was empty, but it was their own island. It looks like one of the own island in the lake. It was in the middle of the lake of the Rudra Sagar. So people of all the communities and the tribal people and the sub-tribal people used to participate there in the state festivals like the Garya, Durga Puja, Buddha Purnima, Karchi, Paus Sankranti, Biju, or Christmas. They used to come there and visit there, and they used to give their rich cultural heritage also. And many beautiful palaces was also there, wildlife sanctuaries, historical temples, palaces, and the museums. So I hope so all the points are clear. Thank you.